Hello all. So in today's lecture, we are going to understand about network topologies. There are five types of network topologies are there: mesh, star, bus, ring and tree. These topologies are used for LAN connection. That means local area network connections of the computers for the internet connectivity. So let's start from the bus topology. It is usually used when a network under consideration is very small, simple and temporarily used. See, it is this kind of. So cable end is to cable end and there are tap between them and each and every computers are connected with it. So it is known as bus topology. These node 1, 2, 3, 4 are computers and the connections are drap line, right? Now, a simple cable is used without additional electronics to amplify a signal or pass it analog from computers to computer. So that's why bus is a passive. It's a passive, it's not active. It doesn't require any kind of component, that is why it's passive topology. When one computer sends a signal on the cable, all the computers on the network receive the information. However, only one computer whose address matches with the destination address stored in the message can accept the information while all other rejects the message. But the advantages of this system is it slows your computer because every time you send it, it will be received to each and every end. Second is ring topology. Ring topology is in this way, in the form of ring. So all nodes are connected to other two nodes with the help of its starting and ending end. This is topology of each computer is connected to the next computer with the last one, right? Connected to the first one, as so on figure. It is used in a high performance signal networks where large bandwidth is necessary. Like video and audio transmission, you can say it's in a WhatsApp group, but it's not worthy right now because we are using wireless communication and this is wired type of. Every computer is connected to the network computer in the ring and each retransmits what it receives from the previous computer. So ring is an active network because it having some connection with previous and front one. Message flow around the ring in one direction, in a clockwise and anti-clockwise, so in a single direction. There is no termination because there is no end to ring. Some ring networks do token passing. A short message called token is passed around ring until a computer wishes to send information to another computer. It stops when it reaches to the origin. So that technique is known as token technique. A computer can modify a token, adds an electronic address and data, sends it to around the ring. Then it came to star topology. In this topology, all the computers are connected via cables and a central location which is called hub. So that is a hub. See, this all computers connected with the hub. This technology is physically active because there is a connection between them. All the connections made with the central hub. This hub is a broadcast. Star network can be active or passive. If hub is not connected, then it should be passive. Active hub requires external power supply, but passive don't. Right? The hub can send the message to all the computers in a star network, or it send the message only to the destination computer in a switch star network. Then it came to the mesh topology. In this topology, every device is physically connected to other device with the point-to-point dedicated link. The term dedicated means the link carries data only between two devices. See, connected to it. So this one is the mesh. Right? There are some advantage of it and some disadvantage of it. Matlab, it is connected with each other in a such a way that if each and every computer is connected by the end-to-end to it. So installation and reconfiguration is too difficult in it because cabling are so much used and you cannot consider if any cable cannot going to work, then it is very hard to identify. Then hardware required to the connect each link input output cable is very expensive. But there are some advantages of it. The use of dedicated links guarantees that each connection can carry its own data. This topology is robust because the failure of one computer doesn't bring down the entire network. It provides security and privacy, easy faults diagnosis. So these are some advantages of mesh. So mesh is like 50-50 we can use. We can use it and we also cannot use it. Then it came to tree topology in a market. This one is tree. So it is nothing but the advanced version of mesh topology. So it is the variation of star. In a star, holes in a free are connected to nodes in a free are connected to central hub that controls entire network. Whereas in a tree, every computer is not plugged into the central hub. Most of them are connected to a secondary hub, which is turned into connected to the central hub, like a way. These are also hub but connected to the central hub. So there are some repeaters used for a signal to increase the distance traveling. You can put repeaters there. Some advantages of it that allows more devices to connect in a single, and it is used for a long distance communication. We are easy isolate a part. If you want to isolate this, you can. Disadvantages are if the central hub fails, the system breakdown. System will be totally breakdown. The cabling cost is very more. See, there are how many cables we are using. So obviously the cabling cost is very more. Digital systems are basically done with this. So thank you.